Blessed Sunday Church. Who here believes that we are worshiping a God who is alive? Amen. Amen. Let's go. Every voice, we sing.
We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will. Cause he opened the prison doors, he parted the raging seas. My God, he holds the victory, yeah. Let's go in the house of the Lord. Let's go in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet, we shall.
With all we are, and we claim your victory. So let it rise. Moment, Father, we just want to adore you. We adore you, Lord God, with all our hearts, Lord. You deserve a worship that is in spirit and in truth, Lord. God, we thank you. We glorify your name. You alone, Lord, are worthy to be praised, God. Thank you, Father. We just honor you right now. We dwell in your presence, Lord, with joy and peace in our hearts, God. We love you, Father.
Creation, Lord.
wants to have the words to say, but this joy is mine. With a thousand hallelujahs, we magnify your name. You alone deserve the glory, the honor, and the praise. Lord Jesus, this song is forever.
darkness tries to hide and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. We sing, how great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And so
above all this. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Can you just lift your hands with me right now? Oh, thank you, Father. Thank you for your grace today, Lord. Lord, today is the first day of the week, and we start the week right today by meeting up with you, acknowledging, Lord, that you are the source of our strength, that you are the source of our joy today, Father God. Give us fresh joy, Lord, fresh strength, Father God. And Lord, give us receptive hearts today that we may hear your voice today, Lord. We want to hear you today, Lord. Equip us, empower us, encourage us today by your word. Holy Spirit, have your way today. Give us teachable hearts today. You may empower us, Lord. Thank you for this beautiful day, Lord. It is a blessed day. It is a beautiful day, for this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it, Lord. We have 10,000 reasons, Lord, to praise you and to honor you today, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Bless our hearts and bless our spirits today. Bless your servant and bless your word today. This we ask in Jesus Christ's name we pray. And all God's people shout, amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Grace-filled Sunday to everyone. Everybody shout, grace, grace, grace. Hallelujah. Welcome to our worship celebration. Welcome to His Life family. Welcome home. Tell your neighbor right now, welcome back. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise God. Are you blessed today, church? Are you empowered today, church? Before you sit down, fist pump your neighbor. Sabihin mo lang sa kanya, mukha kang napakabait today. Come on. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. We can all be seated comfortably on our seats today. And to those of you who are online, hallelujah. We bless you and we appreciate you today. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Are you ready for the word? Yes. Come on, church. Are you ready for the word? Yes. Praise God. Whew. Let me start off with a statement today. And I hope you all agree with me. Life is about learning. Those who agree with me, say amen to that. Life is about learning. Living forward is all about willing to learn. Are you willing to learn today, church? Let me repeat that. Life is all about learning. Living forward is about willing to learn. Everybody say, I'm willing to learn. Come on. Hindi ibig sabihin na nag-graduate ka na sa school, automatic na natuto ka na. Hindi ibig sabihin na you pass all the major exams at school at sasabihin mo na natuto ka na. Hindi ibig sabihin that you really learn. Take it from me. Kasi po, nung ako ay, when I enter college, hindi pa po ako Kristiyano noon. When I entered college, no, first semester, I was forced by my parents to take up engineering course. And nagkataong I hated math. I don't like math. Sino po nakaka-relate dyan? Magtaas ng kamay. Yung mga kasama ko dito na talang, ayaw na ayaw nyo ng math. Taas ng kamay. Come on, I want to see. Okay. Can you imagine, no? Tinulak ako ng mga parents ko. Pinilit ako na take an engineering course. Dahil nung panahon namin, yun ang sikat. You know, cool ka kapag engineer ka nung panahon namin, no? Talagang. So I was forced to endure, you know, the whole semester. Awa naman ng Diyos, pumasa ako. No? Pasang awa, kaya lang puro leakage. Alam niyo yung leakage? Yung you know, talagang lahat ng mga exams ko, cheating, no? Pumasa naman. No? So, second semester, talagang wala po kasi ako natutunan. So, I shifted to another course. Dahil wala po ako natutunan. Kayo po ba'y nandyan pa? Kung yung katabi mo ngayon, estudyante, tanungin mo nga siya, nag-i-enjoy ka ba sa course mo? Come on. Hallelujah. Kung pinilit ka lang, hallelujah, magpakatotoo ka na. Hallelujah. So you see, getting a lot of information does not mean you are learning. Ngayon, we are bombarded with so much information. Pero ibig sabihin niya na you are learning. You see, learning is gaining a heart of wisdom. Learning is about being teachable. Learning is application. Kalimbawa po ngayon, kahit na narinig niyo ako, you are hearing the word of God, pero paglabas mo dito sa lugar na ito, hindi mo in-apply yung word, you have not learned. You have just heard something, you listen to something, you listen, maybe napakinggan mo ang magandang mensahe, but if you did not apply what you've learned today, you did not learn. Everybody said amen to that. Learning is knowing what is really important. Alam na alam mo na totoo kang natuto sa buhay kapag na-determine mo kung ano talaga ang mahalaga sa buhay. Ibig sabihin niyan, natuto ka. Palakpakan mo nga si Lord yan. Hallelujah. Some people learn by experience. Some people learn the hard way. Sino po nakaka-relate dyan? Natuto ka dahil, you know, dumaan ka ng matindi karanasan sa buhay. And some people just never learn. Hindi na natuto sa buhay, kaya naman paulit-ulit na lang ang problema dahil hindi natuto. Look at your neighbor right now. Mukha ba yung natuto na sa buhay? Come on, hallelujah. Huh? Praise God. So our message today has something to do with learning. Everybody say learning. Hallelujah. Written by a man who went through a lot in life. Ang daming pinagdaanan sa buhay. Matitindi, mababaksik, at malulupit na karanasan sa buhay ang kanyang pinagdaanan. He wrote a book, not in a nice, cozy, cool place, like an air-conditioned room, or not in, you know, in, not beside a lake, or he did not write this book overlooking the mountains or somewhere in Palawan. Sino pong wish ko lang na nasa Palawan sila ngayon, ha? Diba? Yung somewhere in Palawan. He did not write that book in a very nice place. In fact, he wrote this book in prison. While in prison, he learned a secret. Everybody say learn. Come on. He wrote a book called The Epistle to the Philippians. And many Bible scholars said that this book, they call it a joyful book. Everybody say joyful. Come on, hallelujah. You know, they call it a joyful book. While he was in prison, he was writing this book. A joyful book. He could have written a sad book, but very ironic. Nasa prison siya, pero sinulat niya joyful book. Kaya makikita mo sa sulat na to, lagi niya sinasabi, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. Yan ang sabi niya sa Philippians 4, 4 and 5. Look at this book. Sabi ni Paul, always be full of joy in the Lord. Sabi niya. I say it again. Rejoice. Parang wala lang. Hallelujah. Tanungin mo yung kanya, malungkot ka ba ngayon? Hallelujah. Okay. Pwede ba natin isigaw yung word na? Ano yan? I say again. Thank you. Rejoice. Yung medyo convincing naman. Everybody say, rejoice. Yun. Thank you. Hallelujah. Let everyone see that you are considerate in all you do. Remember, the Lord is coming soon. Ano ba yung sikreto ni Paul na kahit nasa hindi siya magandang kalagayan, may joy pa rin siya? Ano ba sikreto niya? What was his secret? Ano ba sabi ni Paul? Sabi niya, I have learned. Everybody say, I have learned. Natuto ako, sabi niya. Ano yung natutunan niya? Let's hear it from his own words today. Philippians 4, 10 to 13. Ito po sabi niya. Let's read. Sabi ni Paul, How I praise the Lord that you are concerned about me again. I know you have always been concerned for me, but you did not have the chance to help me. Next line, ito sabi niya, not that I was ever in need, for I have, come on, sabi niya? Thank you po. For I have learned how to be, whoo! That's a word, that's a key word. I have learned how to be with whatever I have. That was the secret of Paul's joy. Sabi niya, natutunan ko. I have learned how to be content in whatever I have. Next line, ito pa sabi niya, I know how to live on almost nothing. You know, kaya kong mabuhay kahit walang-wala ako. Kayo po ba yun nandyan ba? Tinan niyo si Paul, sabi niya, or with everything. I have learned the secret of having, of living in every situation. Natuto ko kahit anumang sitwasyon ko sa buhay, I've learned how to live with it. What, whether it is with a full stomach or empty, with plenty or little, for I can do everything through, yes, come on, through Christ who gives me strength. Come on, give God praise. Hallelujah. Our message today is entitled Learning. Everybody say learning, come on. Learning the secret of being content. Lord, let there be a revelation today. Learning the secret of being content. Notice those words. Every word of this message today, may ibig sabihin yan. Learning. Why learning? You know why? Because contentment does not come naturally to us. We are not by nature contented people. It is not automatic sa atin. Kailangan natin itong matutunan. Everybody said amen. Mismong si Paul, natutunan niya yan. I have learned, sabi niya. Why? Because we are more prone to be restless. We are more prone to be dissatisfied in life. We are more prone to get jealous and envious. Mas madali tayong magselos. Mukha bang selosa yung katabi mo? Come on, come on. Mukha, no? Mas madali tayong mainggit. Yun tayo. Hindi natural sa atin ang makontento. That's why we need to learn. Everybody say learning. Learning the secret. Actually po, it's an open secret eh. But many choose to ignore this truth. Learning the secret of being. Being, to be. Not doing, of being. Ang ibig sabihin yan, contentment is a state of heart, not a state of account. Did you hear that, church? Sa Tagalog, antindi lang, ang contentment, hindi ito yung kalagayan o sitwasyon ng, ang contentment, ito yung kalagayan ng puso, hindi yung kalagayan ng pera mo sa bangko. Kayo po ba'y nandyan pa? Kayo po ba'y nandyan pa? Hallelujah. It is a state of heart, not a statement of your accounts. And everybody said amen. Learning the secret of being content. Paul discovered it and it made him joyful. Now let me put it in a story. Are you ready for a short story? Ready po ba kayong matuto? Nakikinig po ba kayo? Wala po ba sa SM ang isip nyo? Praise God. Thank you. Hallelujah. All right. Let me tell you a short story. Okay? Are you listening na? It is the story of the fisherman. Sabi dito, there was once a rich businessman, isang mayamang businessman, disturbed. He was disturbed to find a fisherman sitting idly by his boat. Walang ginagawa yung fisherman. Nakaupo lang sa tabi ng kanyang bangka. He asked, sabi nung businessman, why aren't you fishing? Sabi nung fisherman, cool lang siya. I have caught enough fish for today. Sabi ng fisherman. Ito yung reply ng businessman. Why don't you catch more fish than you need? Asked the rich man. Sabi niya, no? Sabi naman ng fisherman, what would I do with them? Ano gagawin ko sa maraming isda? Sabi niya, you know what? Sabi nung businessman, you could earn more money and buy a better boat so you could go deeper and catch more fish. Sabi po niya, you could purchase more nets, catch even more fish, and make more money. Sabi nung businessman, soon you will have fleet of boats, marami pang bangka, and be rich like me. Sabi niya. Sabi nung fisherman, so? Sabi niya, what would I do after that? Asked the fisherman. Well, sabi nung businessman, you could sit down and enjoy life. Sabi nung fisherman, ano sa palagay mo ang ginagawa ko ngayon? Kayo po ba yung nandyan pa? Natutunan niyo po ba yung kwento? Hello! What do you think I'm doing now? I'm sitting and I am enjoying life. Everybody said amen to that. Benjamin Franklin said these words, contentment makes a poor man rich. Discontent makes rich men poor. Parang hindi nyo na-gets yan. No? Contentment makes poor men rich. Discontent makes rich men poor. Kaya ang daming nababalitahan na mayayaman pero miserable buhay. Hindi masaya. Learning the secret of being content. How do you do it? Una, are you ready? Lahat po nang gustong matuto ngayong araw na to, magsabi ng, I want to learn. Come on, hallelujah. Learning the secret of being content. How do you do it? Number one, ito po, are you ready? Are you ready? Learn to stop playing the comparison game. Stop it, stop it, stop it. Parang ano, no? Talagang, sabi mo sa katabi mo, hindi galit si pastor. Come on, hallelujah. Ha? Learn. Eto, learn. Unang-una, learn to stop. Everybody say stop. Stop, stop, stop. Thank you. Hallelujah. No? Learn to stop the comparison game. It's a dangerous game. It is not healthy and it's not good to your heart. It's not good for your heart. Stop. I repeat, stop comparing yourselves to others. God created you in His image. You are an original. You are unique. And if you are a senior citizen, you are an antique. Hallelujah. Everybody said amen to that. Yung mga antique, mataas po yung value niyan. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stop comparing yourself to others. 2 Corinthians 10:12, anong sabi sa atin? Sabi ni Paul, ito sabi ni Paul, we're not. Understand, putting ourselves in a league with those who boast that they are superiors. We're not doing this, sabi niya. We're not doing this game. We wouldn't dare do that. It's not our game, sabi ni Paul. But in all this, sabi niya, comparing, grading, and competing, they quite miss the point. Kapag nagkukumpara ka, nakikipag-compete ka, you are always grading and grading, measuring and measuring, sabi ni Paul, you are missing the point of life. Imagine spending your life, the rest of your life, comparing. You're missing the point of life. Stop, stop, stop. It's useless. We are constantly comparing everything around us. We compare our stuff to other people's stuff. We compare our things to other people's things. We constantly compare everything around us. We compare our house to another person's house. We compare our car to another person's car. We compare our gadgets to another person's gadget. We compare our bags. Women, are you with me right now? To another woman's bag. For some men, they compare their watch to another man's watch. Listen, church, the watch was created to tell you the time, not to, pare, you know, pare. Kasi pagbago yung watch, Rolex. Kahit binili lang mo yan sa Divisoria at yung isa, may Rolex, pareho lang yan. Can I hear an amen? Because the watch was created to tell time. Continuously compare. And if we are not careful, listen, church, we will find ourselves catching the virus of covetousness. Gusto ko yun. You're trying to covet. Covet is defined as uncontrolled desire to acquire. You want to get it because a lot of people have it. Gusto mo rin yun kasi meron sila eh. Covetousness ang tawag dyan. The Hebrew word for covet means to pant after. Anong ibig sabihin ng to pant after? Ganito po yan. Yung to pant after is, yun ang pant. I need to get it. I need to have it. Tawag dyan, addict. Yun ang Hebrew word, to pant after, to covet. The Greek word for it is, ito mas matindi ito, to grab tightly that you don't want to let go. Masyadong mahigpit ang kapit mo sa bagay na yan. Ayaw mong i-let go. Now listen, church. Anything that you find it hard to let go owns you. In other words, you don't own that thing, it owns you. Ang tawag dyan, being possessed by your possessions. Hindi na ikaw ang may possession. Yung possession mo nagmamay-ari sa'yo. You have to learn how to distinguish between your need or greed. Baka hindi na need ang pinag-uusapan, baka greed na yan. Ang sabi ni Paul sa 1 Timothy 6, 9 and 10, look at this, look at Paul. But people, look at this, who long to be rich, fall into temptation and are trapped by many foolish and harmful desires. Tawag dyan, greed. That plunge them into ruin and destruction. Ilang mga tao na balitaan natin, you know? Mama sa sweepstakes, nasira buhay. There was this story in the States where nanalo siya ng hundreds of millions of dollars sa loto. You know, na-spoil yung mga anak. The next thing, you know, na-addict yung daughter niya. And then, because of so much drug overdose, the daughter died. You know what this man said? I wish hindi na ako nanalo sa loto. Look at what it says here. For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. And some people craving money have wandered from the true faith and pierced themselves with many sorrows. Wow. Sino po rito yung may natututunan ngayon? Sana masabi mo katulad ni Pablo ngayon. Araw na ito, I have learned. And hopefully you don't learn the hard way. That's why, ano sabi, the love of money is the root of all evil. Warning po. Ito yung warning. Be careful with the get rich quick scheme. Alam niyo yung invest in our group and we will double your money. Ang tawag dyan most of the time, investment scam. Sa Kapampangan, may scam ya. Hello. Yung mga too good to be true. Proverbs 15:27, ano sabi? Greedy people brings trouble to their families. Woo. Nagkakawindang-windang ang pamilya kasi isang miyembro ng pamilya masyadong naging sakim sa pera. Linaw po, hindi po ako, Bible po yan. Greedy people brings trouble to their families. No wonder the number one cause of marriage conflict is about money issue. Ang tawag nga dyan, till death do us part. No? Hindi na po death nagkahiwalay dahil sa maraming utang. Kayo po ba nandyan pa? May natututunan po ba kayo? Are we learning something here? This is a very practical message today. Here is what the richest man in the Bible have learned. Ito po, magsasalita po sa atin ngayon, ang isang pinakamayamang hari sa Bible, si Haring Solomon. Ito sabi niya. Ano sabi ni Haring Solomon? Ecclesiastes 5:10-15. Ano sabi niya? Look at this. If you love money, sabi ni King Solomon, you will never be satisfied. But if you love God, you will be satisfied. And everybody said amen to that. Pero ito sabi niya, if you love money, you will never be satisfied. If you long to be rich, you will never get all you want. It is useless. Ito, tinan niyo yung wisdom ni Solomon. The richer you are, the more mouths you have to feed. Pakakainin mo yung hardinero, yung limang cook, hallelujah, yung sampung kasambahay, are you with me right now? Ha? Yung limang driver, ha? Ang linaw, oh. The richer you are, the more mouths you have to feed. And all you gain is the knowledge that you are rich. Di ba? No? Ayan. Ano kasunod? Eto. Workers may or may not have enough to eat. But at least, they can get a good night's sleep. Wow. Alinaw, no? Pero eto. The rich, however, have so much that they stay awake worrying. No? Oh, diba? Kasi sa sobrang dami ng gastos. Kayo po ba'y nandyan pa? Let me tell you a secret. You want to know a secret? Ha? Yung mga mayaman talaga, gusto nilang magbakasyon, bibili ng rest house. Marami na natutong mayaman ngayon. Anong ginagawa na sa mga rest house nila? Ha? Kasi nadidepreciate, naluluma, amoy, hindi na. Bumili lang rest house nyo. Ah, tapos, twice a year lang pinupuntahan. Okay, natuto na yung marami. Ginawang Airbnb ngayon, no? Diba? Oh, no? Ngayon, a secret, ikaw, huwag ka na bumili. I-rent mo na lang. Are you with me right now? See you rent and then enjoy. Kayo po ba'y nandyan pa? Parang wala akong kausap ngayon. Hallelujah. The rich, however, have so much to stay awake, worry. Next line. Look at this. Here is a terrible thing that I have seen in this world. Sabi niya, people save up their money for a time when they may need it. And they lose it all in some bad deal and end up with nothing left to pass on to their children. Pasaklap. Next line. Ito yung bottom line ni King Solomon. We live this world just as we entered it with nothing. In spite of all our work, there is nothing we can take with us.
Nakakita ka na ba ng libing na hinihila yung lahat ng kanyang kayamanan sa isang limousine, ha? At ibinabaon sa kanyang, Are you with me, church? Are you with me, church? Oh, ano naman natutunan ni Paul? Pareho lang sila ni King Solomon. Sabi ni Paul, 1 Timothy 6:6-8. Sabi ni Paul, yet, true godliness with what? Come on, shout that word. True godliness with contentment is itself great wealth. Pag nakontento ka sa buhay, ikaw ang totoong mayaman. Come on! Ano sabi ni Paul? Look at Paul. After all, we brought nothing with us when we came into the world, and we cannot take anything with us when we leave it. So if we have enough food and clothing, let us be content. Wow. Wow. Hallelujah. Are we learning today, church? Learn to stop the comparison game. That's how you learn how to be content. Secondly, learn to be grateful with what you have. Kaya maraming tao hindi masaya, nadidepress kasi laging tinitignan yung wala siya. Yung wala sa kanya. Nakakalimutan yung ano yung meron sa kanya. If you want to learn the secret of being content, learn to be content with what you have. Everybody said amen to that. Jesus said in Luke 12:15, ang sabi niya, speaking to the people, Jesus continued, sabi niya, be alert and guard your heart from greed and from always wishing for what you don't have. Ang linaw ng word, eh, no? Is the word speaking to us today? For your life can never be measured by the amount of things you possess. Ang buhay hindi nasusukat sa dami ng mga pag-aari mo sa buhay. Yan ang sabi ni Jesus. You see, you don't know what you've got until it is gone. For some, because most of the time, most of us, we take it for granted. Yung mga binigay ng Diyos sa atin, tinitake for granted natin. Kasi tinitignan natin yung wala sa atin eh. COVID-19 made us realize that we need to be grateful with the air we breathe. Have you ever woke up this morning and say, thank God I'm still breathing? You don't know what you've got until it is gone. Sa America, nung pandemic, naubusan ng toilet paper. Kasi alam naman natin sa banyo yung mga Amerikano ginagamit toilet paper. Tayo mga Pilipino, bidet, hallelujah. Social na tayo ngayon, eh, no? Hallelujah. Kayo po ba yung nandyan pa? Ha? Narealize ng mga Amerikano na importante pala yung toilet paper. Pero dati, hindi pinapansin. They take it for granted. Then COVID-19 came. Paul said in Philippians 4:6, I told you about this. Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and what? Thank Him for all He has done. Don't take for granted na yung mga binigay ni Lord sa'yo. pansinin mo naman ang asawa mo. Kayo po ba yung nandyan pa? Pansinin mo naman yung husband mo, yung wife mo. Nag-life group yung mga leading ladies. Sabi nung isa, ang lungkot mo, Mare. Kasi hindi ako pinapansin ni Mister, you know? Oh, kung katabi mo yung asawa, sabi mo, Mister, I love you, I appreciate you. O, di ba? Pansinin mo naman ang mga anak mo. Wag lang, puro trabaho, trabaho, trabaho. Pagod ako, wala akong time sa'yo. Pansinin mo naman yung tatay mo, yung nanay mo. Wag lang puro lesson, lesson. Yun yung mga, pagod ako eh. Online, online. iPad, iPad. Kayo po ba yung nandyan pa? Hello? Be grateful with your life group. Be grateful with your spiritual family. Be grateful with your spiritual leaders. Be grateful with your church. Are you grateful with church? Come on! Are you grateful that you are here today? Why? Because relationships, not things, are more important. Not things. Relationships are more important. Be grateful with what you have. Get rid of the, what I call, the when and then mindset. Alam niyo po ba yan? Did you know this? Huh? Yung when and then mindset. Anong ibig sabihin niyan? No, talagang dapat alisin mo yung when and then mindset. Ano to? Ito yung sinasabi mo na, when this happens, then I'll be happy. Oh? Diba yung, when I get out of school, then I'll be happy. O, oh, diba? Lahat ng mga estudyante dito magsabi ng amen. Hallelujah. Yung, talagang, no? When I pass the board exams, then I'll be happy. No? When I get married, may mga single ba dito? Come on. Are there single people in the house? Say amen. Huh? When I get married, then maybe I'll be happy. May nagkaroon ng maybe eh, no? Talaga. Maybe I'll be happy. No? Talaga. When I get married, you know? Ito, isang payo sa mga single people dito. Kung hindi ka masaya ngayon, hindi ka rin magiging masaya pag nag-asawa ka. Are you with me right now? Ha? Dapat ngayon pa lang masaya ka na. Kasi kung ngayon pa lang malungkot ka na, mas madadamay pa yung mapapangasama, malulungkot din yan. Come on, hallelujah. Come on, palapakan mo nga si Lord dyan. Hindi naman kaya na, kaya ngayon wala ka pang asawa kasi hindi ka pa rin masaya hanggang ngayon. Hallelujah. No? Just saying, hallelujah. Praise God. Whew. When and then mindset. When I get a promotion, then I'll be happy. When I get a long vacation, then I'll be happy. When I get a salary increase, parang ayaw nyo yan, hallelujah. Then I'll be happy. Alam nyo, ganito yan eh. Merong isang among napakayaman ang na-overheard niya yung kanyang, isa sa kanyang mga tagapagluto, yung kanya, isa sa kanyang mga cook, at nagbuntong hininga yung kanyang cook. Na-overheard lang niya, sabi niya, hi, sabi niya, kung magkaroon lang ako ng 5,000 pesos ngayon, I'll be content and I'll be happy, sabi niya. Aba, naawa po yung mayamang amo. Talagang na-move, na-touch. So bumunot ng, kayo po ba yun nandyan pa? Malay mo, yung katabi mo, yan, talagang naawa sa'yo. Ha? Bumunot ng 5,000, no? Hallelujah. At binigay doon sa cook. At talaga naman, tuwang-tuwa yung cook. Yes, thank you po. I did not expect this, but thank you. Sabi niya, so, sayo nung amo. So, nung paglabas nung amo, sinara yung pinto, bigla siya nag-stop, pinakinggan yung totoong reaction niya. Ito yung reaction nung cook. Sabi niya, ba't ko nasabing 5,000? Dapat 10,000 ang nasabi ko! Kayo bumay na dyan ba? Ooh. Tell your neighbor right now, learn, come on, the secret of being content. Everybody said amen. Oh, 1 Timothy, no? Hallelujah. Kayo po ba yun nandyan pa?
1 Timothy 6, 17 to 19. Ito po, pakinggan nyo to. Ito na naman. Sabi ni Paul, teach those who are rich in this world not to be proud and not to trust in their money, which is so unreliable. Their trust should be who richly gives us all we need for our enjoyment. Wow. Next line, anong sabi? Tell them to use their money to do good. They should be rich in good works and generous to those in need, always being ready to share with others. And next line, by doing this, look at this, they will be storing up their treasure as a good foundation for the future so that they may experience true life. Wow. Wow. Tanong. Is it possible to be wealthy and not materialistic? Yes, it is possible. As long as, listen to this, no? Is it possible to be wealthy and not materialistic? Yes, it's possible. As long as, sabi sa Timothy, you don't become proud of your wealth. Can I hear an amen? Can I hear an amen? It's possible. If you don't think you are better than others, hindi mo minamaliit yung kapwa mo. Palakpakan mo nga si Lord yan. As long as you don't put your hope in money, you put your hope in God alone, hindi sa pera mo. As long as you practice generosity. Look at your neighbor right now. Sabihin mo sa kanya, mukha kang galante ngayon. Hallelujah. Bubunot na yan ng 1,000. Hallelujah. Huwag sanang marinig na sana 2,000 na. Hallelujah. No? That's why one of the things, one of the antidote to selfishness and greed is tithing. Wala na nag-amen, no? Hallelujah. You know, when you tithe, you're not giving God a favor. You're doing yourself a favor. God doesn't need your money. Ang ayaw lang ni Lord, money owns you. You're possessed by your possessions. Yan ang ayaw ni Lord. Greed ang tawag dyan. Then you will experience true life. Be grateful with what you have. Paul said, again, let's read what he said in Philippians 4, 11 and 12. Sabi ni Paul, not that I was ever in need, for I have learned, sabi ni Paul, how to be content in whatever I have. Powerful words. I know how to live on almost nothing or with everything. I have learned the secret of living in every situation, whether it is with a full stomach or empty, with plenty or little. And everybody said, amen. Give God praise. Learn to stop the comparison game. Learn to be grateful with what you have. And last but not the least, this is the most important. Learn that everything you need, everything I need, is found. Come on. Only in Jesus Christ. Give God praise to that. Come on. Amen. You
Ito po yung natutunan ni David. Sabi niya sa Psalm 23 verse 1, "The Lord is my shepherd. I have..." Wow, hallelujah. Palakpakan mo si Lord. Come on. Salamat po. Salamat po. Sige nga, basahin nga natin. Sige po, I wanna hear it loud and clear. Come on, everybody. Come on. Woo! Everybody say woo to that. Hallelujah. Si sabi ni David, ang Panginoon ang aking pastol, hindi na ako mangangailangan pa kung siya yung pastol ko. He knows my need. He will provide for all my needs. Yan ang sabi ni Paul sa Philippians 4:19. Paul said, "And this same God who takes care of me will supply," come on church, "all your needs from His glorious riches which had been given to us in what? In Christ Jesus." Can we give Jesus Christ a great, great hand of praise? Hallelujah. This means that my joy is not based on my status in life, but in my relationship with Jesus Christ. Did you hear that, church? Your joy is not based on your status in life. It means that Jesus is enough for me. How many can say that today? Jesus? Masasabi mo ba ngayon yan? Jesus? You are enough. You know, somebody said, you know, I love these words. Sabi niya, when you have nothing left but God, you realize He is enough. Powerful words. When you have nothing left but God, you realize He is enough. True joy comes from finding my security, my satisfaction, my contentment, not in what I own, but whose I am. The Bible says, you belong to Jesus Christ. You were bought with a great Christ. You were bought with the blood of Jesus Christ. That is why you are able to say, I am content in Christ. Can you say that right now? Come on, everybody say, come on, with your heart, I am content in Christ. When you realize that, listen, church, when you realize that you are content in Christ, that is why you don't measure your self-worth by your net worth. Ayan, usong-uso ito eh. No? Ano ba yung net worth ni Bill Gates? Ano ba net worth ni Warren Buffett? Ano ba yung net worth ni Elon Musk? Huh? Para bagang nandun yung halaga ng buhay mo sa dami ng pera mo. When you are content in Christ, you don't measure your self-worth by your net worth. You don't think that your value is related to your valuables. Ang halaga ng buhay mo, walang kinalaman sa mga valuables mo sa buhay. In Christ, you are forgiven, you are accepted, and you are valued. Give God praise, church! Everything we need is found only in Jesus Christ. I love what C.S. Lewis said. Sabi ni C.S. Lewis, God cannot give us happiness and peace apart from Himself because it is not there. There is no such thing. Alam niyo ko, bisan, Lord, Bigyan po ko ng peace, bigyan ako ng joy. Hindi niya pwedeng ibigay sa iyo na hindi siya kasama. Siya lang kasi ang makapagbibigay sa iyo ng totoong kapayapaan at totoong joy. He is the source of your peace and your joy. And everybody said amen to that. F.F. Bruce said this word, sabi niya, the soul's deepest thirst is for God Himself, who has made us so that we can never be satisfied without Him. Kaya ba malungkot ang buhay mo kasi hinahanap mo sa iba? You're looking at the wrong places. You can only find your satisfaction in God alone. True contentment is to be satisfied in Christ alone. Nothing more, nothing less, and nothing else. Only in Christ. Give God praise. Let me end up with this verse today, Psalm 17:15. Sabi dito, but as for me. Pwede mo bang sabihin yan? Come on, with yung tapik sa puso mo, sabi, but as for me. Whew. Sabi ng manunulat, my contentment is not in wealth, but in seeing you and knowing all is well between us, Lord. And when I awake in heaven, I will be fully satisfied, for I will see you face to face, the author and finisher of our faith. Would you stand with me right now, church? Paul learned the secret of being content in Christ. Bow your heads and close your eyes right now for just for a little moment. Those of you who are online, just make this moment, you know, a quiet moment, a precious moment between you and God. Kayo lang ni Lord. Usap lang kayo. Pabayaan mo lang na payapain ka niya. Pabayaan mo lang na pumasok sa puso mo ang katotohanan na to. Na hindi ka magiging payapa at maligaya sa buhay kung wala siya sa buhay mo. Panginoong Diyos, sa oras pong ito, gusto po naming matuto sa buhay. Patawarin niyo po kami kung pinahintulutan namin na agawin ang mundong ito, Panginoon, ang aming kapayapaan at kaligayahan na sa iyo lang masusumpungan. Patawarin niyo po kami kung naghanap kami ng ligaya sa iba, hindi sa iyo. Patawarin mo kami sa aming pagkukulang. Patawarin mo kami sa aming pagkukumpara. Patawarin mo kami kung nakatingin kami doon sa wala sa amin. Patawarin mo kami kung nagkulang kami sa salamat, sa meron kami. Sa oras na tutulungan niyo po kami na makontento kay Kristo lamang at wala ng iba. Sa oras pong ito, palayain mo po kami. Palayain mo ang aming mga puso. Pagalingin mo ang aming mga kaluluwa. Set our spirits free today, Lord. At pumayapa at totoong maging fulfilled ang aming buhay dahil lamang sa iyo, Jesus. Alam ko, Panginoon, sa oras na ito, kami po ay iyong kinatagpo. At alam ko, sa oras na ito, kami ay iyong pinalaya sa lahat ng aming kabigatan. Pinapagaling mo yung mga na-depressed. Pinagaling mo yung mga malulungkot. At sa oras na ito, nasumpungan nila na ikaw lamang, Jesus, ang aming totoong kaligayahan. Sambahin natin siya. At gawin natin ang awit na ito na isang panalangin. Hallelujah.
Kapayapaan nagmumula sa'yo. Kaligayahan na kami sa nang hahanapin pa. Wala nang nanaisin pa, kundi mamalagi sa wala nang papantay sa'yo. Nag-iisang Panginoon, kaya ang naisin ng puso ko sa piling mo.
Pwede ba natin sabay-sabay natin awitin ito at gawin natin itong panalangin? Come on, if you can lift your hands and make this your prayer today. Come on. Hallelujah.
Kapayapaan,
yes, Lord.
Nagmumula sa'yo.
Opo, Panginoon.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Kaligayahan na kami sa piling mo.
Everybody now.
Wala
are bowed, all eyes are closed. Marahil meron pong mga narito, those who are here today or those who are on our church online, maybe, just maybe, some of you have never come to the fullness of experiencing what Jesus offers us. The thief came to steal, to kill, and to destroy, but Jesus said, I have come that you might have life and have it to the fullest, a fulfilling, satisfying life. And all it takes for you is magbalik loob ka lang sa Diyos. And may take a simple prayer. Would you pray this prayer with us? You know, with faith in your heart. Sabihin mo lang, Dear Lord Jesus. Come on, say with all your heart. Say, Dear Lord Jesus. Today, I realize I am not happy without you. Hindi po ako masaya kung wala ka. Jesus, I admit that I am a sinner. Forgive me. Cleanse me. Change me. And set me free today. I open my heart and I receive you as my Lord and Savior. I receive the gift of eternal life. I believe in my heart and I confess in my mouth that you came, you died for me, you rose from the dead to give me eternal life. Today, I receive this gift of eternal life. Thank you, Jesus. From this day forward, I will love you, honor you, and serve you. Thank you, Jesus. In your name I pray. And we all say amen. And amen. Give the Lord a big, big hand of praise for that. If you prayed that prayer with all your heart, you know, the Bible says, if anyone is in Christ, he is now a new creation. The old life is gone and the new life has begun. Welcome, welcome to your new life in Jesus Christ. And that new life will never, never grow old. Can we give the Lord another mighty hand of praise for that? Praise God, praise God. Are you blessed today, church? Amen. Can everybody say, my heart is full, Lord? Yes, Lord, lift your hands. I want to bless you with a prayer. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord makes His face shine upon you. The Lord bless you with a contented heart. The Lord bless you with answered prayers. The Lord bless your family. The Lord bless your life. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And all God's people say, amen and amen. God bless you, church.